And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. He weighed in 153.5 pounds. He stands 5'10" tall. He is your 2007 silver medalist at the International Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu Tournament in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Representing Regina Infight Jiu-Jitsu out of Regina, Saskatchewan, ladies and gentlemen, Chris Desitel.
In the fear. You can admire me if you can catch one of your way. You see the testosterone, see the toasters right on my lap.
So Estelle looks like he's ready.
I got an arsenal of infantry. I'm
he's got a punch that he likes to call the wadoosh. We'll see if he can pull that out tonight.
Vaseline allowed only on the face.
You never know, Lane might surprise us here. He looks like he's in decent enough shape. Chris is pretty revved up.
Once again, your seventh fight, sponsored by Bellamy Kia, is a lightweight bout consisting of 2 5-minute rounds. And the man inside the cage, in charge of the action at the bell, Mr. Sean Quinn.
There we go, Dale. Daryl Lane Klekta versus Chris Desitel.
Chris Desitel in the black shorts, Lane Klekta in the red shorts. They tap gloves, and it's on.
Huge double leg here, straight to the ground. Chris
Klekta's
is going to pass
of a,
the guard.
A little bit of a guillotine on there. That might be a problem for Chris.
Chris is pushing off the
kinda,
elbow over
he
his head.
He kind of fell right into that. But he's got a half guard. He's going to try to crank it. Looks like it's fairly tight. He needs to get underneath that if he wants to finish it.
He does not want to bring his body to the same side as the guillotine. That would put the choke on tighter. So
unfortunately,
he needs to go to the other side.
You know, with
there
only
he brings it out.
Such little training, that might have been a dangerous move if he would have had a few more years behind him.
Some punches, yep. body head.
Lane holding him close here, which is going to...
Body head.
Chris isn't going to get as much power on those punches as he'd like in this situation.
Chris is going to work to pass the guard. Here we go. He's
looks like he's got side mount. And he'll work to full mount.
Full mount. Very
and,
swift.
He'll frame off the head, try to frame off his head and try to make some space.
Rain down some punches.
And we'll see what happens here. Again, Lane just holding on. Ooh, those body shots have got to be taking their toll.
You can already see some redness building on up
Lane.
On the latissimus dorsi and the serratus anterior. Mm-hmm. Here we go. The referee's got to be sharp here.
Yeah, Lane's doing a good job to cover up. I think Des is going to have to put him to sleep. Going to try to buck him off here.
Or Lane potentially trying to bring those feet up into the armpits of Chris Desitel. That's another way to escape.
Looks like he might be setting up for a an armbar here. Key lock.
Oh, that's
there
over.
It is.
You got to tap from that or you're going to lose your rotator cuff.
Dez took a little chapter from the Swainson book of submissions, eh? That was good. That's what he wanted.
Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for these two fighters.
Jiu-jitsu winning the day there. Comes
while we await the official decision, we'd like to take this
one
time
of the first moves you learn in jiu-jitsu is the key lock.
Key lock. Mount. Day one right there.
Yep. Yep. It does you through no matter how many years. How many years you've been doing it. You can pull those submissions. You just keep adding stuff in jiu-jitsu. Keep adding more and more moves to your armamentarium. And you can pull out the one you learned on the first day. Whatever, it works.
Exactly. Most elite fighters have like six submissions that they hit all the time. It's just a matter of how you set them up and how you get there. Here we go with the judge. Here we go with the judge's decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, the official results are in. And your winner by tap out at 2 minutes 23 seconds of the first round, fighting out of the red corner, Chris Desitel.
Chris Desitel, winner by key lock submission tonight, improves his record to